Hello and welcome to this special edition of Bunkum Weekly, which I should call Bunkum Yearly because in this episode we're going to go over all of the great things Bunkum County has done throughout 2014. Now normally when I film these episodes I like to come to you from a scenic location to show you all of the great things in Bunkum County. But because of what we're talking about today and all of the great things that Bunkum County's been doing, I figured it would be best to come from our county offices, where our Board of Commissioners and our county employees work really hard to make all of these things come to light. And it's kind of cold outside.
Now you should keep up with BuncombeCounty.org so you can catch these great county editions as they happen throughout the year. BCTV is also a great resource for county information. So for more, you can always stream our channel live at bctv2.pegstream.com. You can check us out on Charter, channel 192, or you can just view our programs individually as we upload them all to YouTube. Just visit buncombecounty.org/YouTube.
First things first. Bunkum County has recently been put on the worldwide manufacturing map by opening their GE Aviation Ceramic Matrix Composite factory here in Asheville. What is a ceramic matrix composite? Well, it's basically going to do to metal what metal did to wood in the aviation industry. It's going to revolutionize it, and it's all here in Bunkum County.
It's just amazing that we are here just several months ago, I think a little further down this parking lot, and I remember they showed me this lot with all the men and women in the blue shirts on where this new building was going to go, and I remember going, how? And look what's happened in such a beautiful short period of time. GE Aviation is just helping leading the way with aviation growing throughout North Carolina. Manufacturing is where you build things and make things and innovate things and design things. And that's the future of North Carolina, and it's the past of North Carolina. And it's an industry that we have to continually respect and grow and support in any way we can.
The celebration is about the future. This facility will not only employ our children, it will employ our grandchildren and their children. In 50 years, the people of Bunkum County will be coming here to this fine facility in this beautiful valley to build innovative products for the entire world. But it didn't happen by chance, and it's often said it takes a long time to become an overnight success.
Another great construction that was completed in 2014 in Bunkum County is the new Public Safety Training Facility. This great two-story center will feature academic programs on everything from law enforcement training to fire and rescue, emergency medical service, criminal justice, and much more.
This is a 30-acre facility. The construction on this particular center began July 11th of last year. The cost is $5.9 million. And ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you that the best investment a local government can make is in public safety training, public safety appreciation, and retaining the best men and women to protect us. We're going to support 7,000 students each year, 17 classrooms, and some of them are pretty cool. Let me read them out. Got an EMS class, laboratory. You have a crime scene laboratory where we can actually practice how we do the crime scenes. You have an ambulance truck bay. You have a large assembly area, armory, cardiac lab. You have a scale model, and we can actually talk about deploying various types of emergency service, law, fire control when we have disasters that are widespread. And we burn buildings on purpose here. We burn them so we can learn how to put them out good.
Speaking of keeping us safe, the Bunkum County Sheriff's Office has a new team member with a real nose for the job. Puns are fun. So let's all get together and welcome Samson to the Sheriff's Office. He is their new person-borne weapon and explosives canine.
In our continued efforts to make Bunkum County schools a safer place for our kids, the Bunkum County Sheriff's Office has just acquired what we refer to as a gun vapor dog. This canine is a little different than the other canines that we have available to us. As far as I know, we're one of the first school systems and sheriff's offices around to use this type of dog and a dog that's trained in this type of discipline to detect firearms. And that's what this dog does in particular. basically last year we had an event at a Buncombe County school where we had a discharge of a weapon outside of a sporting event. And that got a lot of us thinking, along with Tony Baldwin and the school administration, about how we can make those sporting events and those things safer, both when adults and our kids attend. So what this dog does is it goes through the crowd with the handler, and this is Officer Ben Davidson, Deputy Ben Davidson with our school resource officer program. He will be handling the dog through the course of its career here. The dog will go through the crowd, and the dog is specifically trained to lock on the scent of a firearm, and it will go up and alert the handler and set by that person.
Buncombe County has had many great new facility openings in 2014. Now, they not only make life better for our community, but they've received national and worldwide recognition for their services. One of these new facilities is the Humane Alliance Training Center. This state-of-the-art building will teach veterinary students from across the country.
What a glorious, glorious day. And on behalf of Buncombe County Commission, Chairman Gann is here with us. This is unbelievable, and we say thank you to the ASPCA, PetSmart Charities, but most of all, the Humane Alliance. The Humane Alliance held together with a vision from Bill McKelvey, and who is smart enough and brilliant enough to hire Keita Mazina. The Humane Alliance has always been at the table with a sole purpose to help the community. And now we celebrate this extraordinary building, $3.8 million, and no tax dollars have gone into this.
Veterinarians are on the front lines in the fight to save lives. They represent the main point of contact and oftentimes the most trusted point of contact for pet owners. And through spay-neuter surgeries, they wield the most effective tool that we have in our fight to end the needless euthanasia and suffering of homeless pets. The work being done here at Humane Alliance is making spay-neuter faster and smarter everywhere, touching millions of lives. And as we've heard, the numbers speak for themselves. 23,000 surgeries here, 800 vets and externs trained already, over 135 clinics opened up in the US and Canada. All that started right here in Asheville. And in case you're wondering, this facility is booked through May 2016.
Well, students, teachers, community organizations, and volunteers have all gathered together at Pisgah Elementary School to build a wetland. Now, this wetland is not only an aesthetic addition to the grounds at Pisgah Elementary School, but it unearths a wealth of information and education for the students there.
I'm Renee Ray with Buncombe Soil and Water Conservation District, and we are out here. We have some students and volunteers working on installing a wetland. And the reason we're installing this wetland is the school already had a problem down here that was wet, and they didn't really want to drain it. They wanted to keep the wetland habitat for outdoor classroom kind of setting. So we worked with them to install this wetland that is capturing stormwater runoff from the parking lot and the roof. And how that works is it kind of filters through the wetland and it improves the water quality. And that's what the soil and water conservation really works to do, is improve the water quality. We're using several different programs to help kind of assist in funding with this. One of those is the Community Conservation Assistance Program. We call that CCAP. And we also have a grant for an Outdoor Environmental Learning Center through the Foundation of Soil and Water and Walmart, and that's $2,500 that assists in an outdoor classroom. So we're hoping to install some benches out here and a little observation deck.
I am shoveling mulch and putting it in the buckets, and then we go and dump them in the wetland area. I love gardening. At home, I have a bunch of peacocks and dogs and chickens and geese, and I always have to clean up after them. So I also dig their nests. You get dirty. All kids love to get dirty.
You're watching Buncombe County's 2014 Year in Review. Now, the next thing I'm going to tell you about is the opening of the brand new STEM school, who just began classes this past August. STEM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math. And they had a press conference earlier this year to celebrate the opening of this new school.
Welcome to the dedication ceremony of this beautiful Minotaurium. It will be an integral part
of our Buncombe Discovery Academy for STEM education that will be opening in August. You know, prior to June 2011, the facility that we're currently in, that is now being renovated, it was called the Career Education Center. And our school board had the wonderful vision at the time to look at closing that particular center with the intent to reopen it. But the vision was, as they reopened this facility, that it would be a 21st century model of innovation and academic relevance.
One of the things I know today, guaranteed, is that within 24 months, we're going to be bringing teachers here from all over North Carolina to observe the important work that's going to be going on in these classrooms, focusing on inquiry and the development of skills and the acquisition of knowledge, the kind of community that meets the individual needs of students. So my prediction is that 24 months down the road, not just in Western North Carolina, but all across North Carolina, people are going to be coming to see the wonderful work being made possible here at the Academy.
Now, if you've never heard of Cycle to Farm, it's a great organized bike ride program that promotes local food, farming, and agrotourism that's really been taking off in the South lately. Now, they've had 3 Cycle to Farm events in North Carolina this past year, and one of them took place here in Buncombe County.
Cycle to Farm is a metric century enjoyed by about 300 bicyclists. If you participate in Cycle to Farm, you show up at the start line and you're greeted with coffee and usually some sort of a treat. Then after the start, about every 15 miles, you get to stop at a farm, refill your water bottle, sample the farm's product, and decide if you'd like to purchase some of the product. Don't worry about carrying it back to the finish because volunteers will do that for you. When you arrive at the fabulous after party, you're greeted with a farm-to-table meal prepared with ingredients from the farms that you just visited and New Belgium beer. New Belgium is our presenting sponsor for Cycle to Farm. The routes that we choose for Cycle to Farm are use mostly country rural roads, and they're very beautiful. They are quite challenging, but they do introduce riders to a new area of the community that they may not have experienced before.
The Buncombe County Library System is a great resource for education and fun for the entire family. It is not just a place to quietly check out a book and read. Now, they sponsor many great events, and normally in this show, I tell you about some upcoming events. But because this is the year-end review show, I'm going to tell you about all of the great events they had in 2014 that you can look forward to next year.
Every year, they have a summer reading program, which is a great resource to keep kids reading and their minds sharp during the schoolless months of the year. This year was no exception. The theme in 2014 was Fizz Boom Read and featured a lot of great science-themed activities for kids. Throughout the year, however, the library sponsor everything from book clubs for adults, the Dollywood Penguin Players and Preschoolers We Love You shows for kids, the Teen Awesome Group for teenagers, movie nights, jazz and poetry evenings, knitting groups, and much more. So again, check out buncombecounty.org/library and see what our library system has that you would be interested in.
Now, as you could tell from your mailbox, the television ads, the radio ads, and the cold calls, 2014 was an election year. Well, the elections are over and the results can be found online at buncombecounty.org/vote.
While the results for Buncombe County don't necessarily relate to statewide winners, new to office this year is Patrick McHenry for District 10. Incumbent Mark Meadows remains the representative for District 11. State Senate winner for District 48 is Tom Apodaca, and for District 49 is Terry Van Dyne. Commissioners Ellen Frost and Brownie Newman both won re-election campaigns, and newcomer to the Board of Commissioners this year is Miranda DeBrule of District 3. Sheriff Van Duncan also won his re-election campaign. Again, to see a full list of the winners, please visit buncombecounty.org/election.
Well, congratulations to all of the election winners. And we want to give a special welcome to Miranda DeBrule, who is now on the Buncombe County Board of Commissioners representing District 3.
DeBrule grew up in Buncombe County and currently lives in Leicester with her husband and 2 children. She's a small business owner as well as a registered nurse. If you missed the opportunity this year to meet your commissioners, don't worry, because next year they're holding another tour beginning in August. In these tours, the Board of Commissioners will visit locations in each voting district to not only introduce themselves, but to listen to your concerns or what you would like to continue in Buncombe County. So keep an eye out at buncombecounty.org for the schedule to appear later in 2015.
Well, Buncombe County had many triumphs in 2014. However, we were also exposed to a new recreational drug that cost three North Carolinians their lives. The Buncombe County Health and Human Services Department wants you to be aware of the dangers of acetyl fentanyl.
Addiction is costing as much as heart disease, diabetes, cancer in our community, and it has become the leading cause of death for 25 to 54-year-olds in our state over motor vehicle accidents. So we are seeing the impact of this as we continue to see additional issues come up, the latest being the lacing of heroin or the availability of fentanyl in our communities. We've seen three deaths in this state in the last couple of months. They're lacing heroin with that particular substance because it's cheaper and it gets a very quick high, but it's almost always fatal. So we're continuing to try to find ways to work with our community to prevent that. In addition, we're seeing additional cases of meth in our community, methamphetamines. So we know that we have an addiction problem here. We have the highest rate of hepatitis C in our community in this state, and that's mostly due to injection drug use. So we know we have an issue. So we need to make sure that people understand the issue. We need to make people understand what they need to do about it, how they can educate their children, how they make sure that their children do not have access to drugs of any kind, and how we talk about addiction in this community, working with law enforcement to make sure that we keep the drugs off the streets as much as we can.
Now, 2014 got off to a great start here in Buncombe County on January 14th, when the Board of Commissioners voted unanimously to build a $40.5 million new Asheville Middle School. Construction already began this past May to bring this technological, safe, and modern facility to the youth of Buncombe County.
And just thank you to the staff for thinking of ways to pursue these kinds of investments in a really cost-effective way. And I think thanks are also owed to the past commissions that have helped the county get into a really strong position in terms of the credit rating of the county, which allows us to make these substantial investments at a remarkably low borrowing rate. So we get a lot of value for the taxpayers, and the past commissioners deserve a lot of credit for being putting us in a position to access these funds at among the lowest rates of any government in the country. So thank you.
Any other comments or questions? If not, I'll call the question. All in favor of the resolution as to include the Asheville Middle School not to exceed $40.5 million provision, say aye.
Aye. Aye.
All opposed, no. Motion carries 7-0. Thank you.
Asheville Middle School isn't going to be the only new school in the future in Buncombe County. We're also going to get a new Inca Middle School.
In 2013, the Buncombe County Board of Commissioners approved the purchase of the land on Sand Hill Road for the new school. This new facility should help alleviate overcrowding at the current Inca Elementary and Inca Middle School. Just recently, however, the county school board took another step towards construction by agreeing on a contract with the construction manager for the project. It's expected the new Inca Middle School will be open for the fall 2016 school year.
Not only is Inca Candler getting a new middle school, but the Buncombe County Board of Commissioners recently passed a $1.3 million sports project for them. This is going to be 90 acres of sports fields that will be built over the next 6 years.
Originally, we were proposing about a 40-acre site for a sports complex. That has evolved over the years, and today, this is the current master plan for this property. You can see where the demoed area was is the what is labeled on this site the retail component. You'll see where the bridge is coming off of 1923 into the property, and you'll also see the proposed sports complex, and then you'll see the actual commerce part of this property, and you can see where Jacob Home is on the front, You can see where Buncombe County Schools purchased the property for the intermediate school. You can see where New Belgium has located their new facility. You can see where Wicked Weed is going in the former Shell building. And then at the bottom of that hill is where we're proposing one section of the ball fields. The sports complex has had several gyrations. Originally, we were doing a layout. It was a real estate broker and an engineer doing the original layout. We then hired a landscape architect to help us. And then most recently, we have hired Jason Gilliland, who is a landscape architect, to help with this layout.
Another great change in 2014 comes in the form of an upgrade at the Buncombe County Sheriff's Office. To ensure better transparency and accountability, officers of the sheriff will now be wearing body cameras. Now, we aren't the only law enforcement agency in the country to have body cameras on our officers, but we will be one of the few to have them on all of our patrol officers.
What we are doing today is announcing the use of the VVU body cams for our patrol officers and also our sheriff's community enforcement team. What we started with several years ago was in-car cams, and the problem for a sheriff's office or municipal police department, whereas the highway patrol probably does 90% of their at the point of interaction videotaping around a vehicle, we probably do 90% plus away from a vehicle. So we captured very little of our day-to-day activities with a vehicle camera. We're not doing this because of any types of complaints that we currently get or issues we currently have with our community. I honestly feel that our sheriff's office has a very transparent relationship with the community, but in hopes of keeping that positive and moving forward, as well as giving our officers another tool that really kind of protects them in many ways as well, we are going to initiate the use of this technology.
Buncombe County is fortunate to have an organization like Alliance Auto Gas in our region. They provide an alternative form of gasoline that not only reduces fuel emissions, but it's less expensive. They recently celebrated the grand opening of their new facility on Sweeten Creek Road, where they talked about what they have in store for the future.
The work that we'll be doing in our Vehicle Technology Center here in Asheville, North Carolina, is essentially geared to providing alternative fuel systems to fleet customers. That will include engine platform development work and pre-certification work, providing the opportunity for them to reduce harmful emissions by over 30%, and we have experienced 35% reductions in fuel costs for our fleet customers over the past 8 years.
There are many different alternative fuels in the marketplace that offer green solutions to fleet customers. We feel ours is one of the most easy to adopt and to deploy into the field. Again, this facility allows us to have that customized solution delivered and engineered, so when the customer gets it to their point of business, it's a simple install and they're up and going, you know, having positive, you know, carbon impact in the environment day one. The future of Blossman Services in North Carolina is very bright. You know, this technology is being adapted more and more every day, and as it does, will create more and more demands for us to get customized solutions here. You know, whether it be in regards to lawn mowers and off-road garden equipment, you know, heavy-duty Class 8 tractors, or our traditional space into the delivery fleets and municipal fleets of the nation, this facility will best enable us to be able to bring that product to the market in a very quick and very reliable manner.
Now, if you watched the news at all in 2014, you saw that domestic violence took the main stage for quite a while. Well, coincidentally, Buncombe County was partnering with many local organizations and businesses to come up with a new domestic violence plan. This new plan is called Enough, and it hopes to bring an end to domestic violence in Buncombe County.
In 2013, we had 5 intimate partner domestic violence homicides. So with the conversation that had been going on, which was really highlighted by those tragedies in 2013, a group to include retired judge Rebecca Knight came together to draw empirical information and really look around the state as well as the country to look at best practice models that were out there in place and working to reduce those intimate partner domestic violence homicides.
I'm very excited that in Buncombe County we have identified not one model, but several models that are rendering great results in other communities, and we're going to bundle them together. And bundling them together, I think we are going to make a strong statement that we have had enough violence against women in this community, and that offenders will be prosecuted and they will be punished for violent behavior.
We have a very strong community in the area of domestic violence. We have specialized domestic violence court. We have agencies such as Helpmate and Our Voice who help victims. We have an aggressive prosecutor's office who attacks domestic violence in the courtroom. The clerk's office helps with the civil restraining orders and domestic violence. But we have found that there's a need to improve those services and reach out more to victims. So we've developed a comprehensive plan that has basically 5 points of attack on domestic violence. One is a high-risk domestic violence team. Two is the use of an evidence-based lethality assessment so we can identify victims who are in the most danger. Three is a focused deterrence program where we can get offenders, get their attention, and let them know that our community doesn't tolerate domestic violence. Four is an electronic monitoring program to alert victims and law enforcement when an offender has violated the conditions of his inclusion or exclusion zones. The fifth prong is a cross-system dialogue to make sure that we're communicating as a community and as professionals to expedite conveying information where it needs to go as soon as possible.
Well, we'll end today's 2014 recap of Buncombe County appropriately by talking about a time capsule that was buried right underneath my feet in front of the judicial complex in Buncombe County.
We would like to think of these year-end specials as their own form of time capsules, letting the future of Buncombe County know all about the great progress we make to make our county greener, kinder, healthier, safer, and smarter. The time capsule buried in front of the courthouse will be unearthed 100 years from now in 2113, and will be a reminder of how far we've come. And we'll also let the future know that no matter what time you come from, we're all citizens of Buncombe County, and we can only hope the changes we make today will make life better for them.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this look back on 2014 Buncombe County. Now, clearly I couldn't cover everything that Buncombe County government did in 2014 because it was a lot. But if you check out buncombecounty.org, you can read all about everything they've done and everything that's going to happen in 2015. Now, I hope you had a great year, and we'll see you in 2015.